I still have every player out there thinks that they're an NBA player or wants to be an NBA player. And I think each player deserves the right to be there because it is their dreams.
You know, whether he gets drafted or not, he's, you know, you've given him the shot. You know, that's all he can ask for.
You get here and you show that you're a player, then, you know, you're in the NBA.
Now I'm shooting with no tissue. This is my issue, I'm not kidding. Y'all say it's letting the fly tall, living like y'all. So, I don't pay you no mind.
But what it all comes down to is, can a guy play at the next level? Get on with your half-ass plan.
I know you will watch when I... Over the last two seasons, he is the only player in NCAA Division I to average 20 or more points, 5 or more rebounds, and 5 or more assists. A 6'4", senior guard from Wilmington, Delaware. One of the greatest players to ever don the maroon and gold. Number 5, A.J.
AJ English from Iona is a player who was needed to score a lot of points on his college team. He's a tremendous scorer. He's a guy who, again, when the other team is game planning to stop you, everybody in the arena who bought a ticket knows that you're the featured scorer, and still you're able to find a way to get 20 plus points every single night.
I'm blessed. I thank God for having a brother that's right there for me. You know, you don't have to call anybody to come rebound for you, or you can rebound for them, or, you know, playing against them, you know, we'll find anywhere, you know, even if it's in the kitchen. Yeah, my dad played in the NBA for 2 years. I mean, he kind of, you know, backed away and just let me and my brother, you know, find a love for the game first, you know, didn't really want to force it on us. But, I mean, how can you, you know, watching him play and just being around basketball, of course you're going to create a love for it. She was really the first one that put a basketball in my hands, you know. I mean, my dad wasn't around through basketball, traveling and stuff like that. So she was the one to take us to my first YMCA game, Boys and Girls Club, everywhere, you know. It was just school, tournaments, AAU. At first, it was just her sister played basketball when she was young, but she stopped.
On the other hand, the NBA people are interested in how well he can play point guard. And what they saw was he's a tall point guard. This week, he was able to make the kinds of passes where he didn't just hit the guy coming off a screen for a jump shot. Every point guard can do that. He didn't just, you know, play the pick and roll well. He saw things happening on the weak side as well as the strong side. If all of a sudden there was a defender napping or cheating too much into the lane, he would zip that ball right in there. He has a lot of pizzazz to his game. He has a lot of what you call agility and speed, but at the same time, he has the vision. And not a lot of guys have both of those things. In other words, he's going to be able to make his own shot because he's quick and he's agile and he's got all the, you know, the head fakes and the hesitations and all those things that you look for. But he also has the floor vision of a true point guard. He's enjoying the heck out of being out there, and it's very evident when you watch him. And that's something that we love to see, because over a long career playing hundreds of games, you need to have that deep love and affection for the game of basketball. And he has that. And it's really, as you can tell, he has intensity, but at the same time as he has intensity, he's enjoying himself.
Central Park West somewhere? What you gonna buy your mama, son?
House.
Come on. A big house. It's the will of the man. It ain't the skill of the man.
Man, like he got game.
Don't be afraid of nobody. Take it. Take it. Strong,
I started to make some noise. I say maybe my sophomore year going into my junior year. Iona was one of the team. I mean, it was more like I was just thankful, thank God, that they had a scholarship offer, and it was a great opportunity for me, and they just come off, you know, tournament run. And I didn't play really at first. I didn't have a problem with it. Just like I felt like I should have been playing, you know, but I mean, I'm sure everybody that sits on the bench feels the same way. So I mean, like I said, it helped me show how I can be a role player. Like some people, I feel like when they become the man, they just like, all right, they can do whatever they want. When I became a man, or just I'm getting all the playing time, all the shots or whatever, I was blessed. Like I was thankful for it, and I try to take advantage of it. Like I was in the gym, I knew I was gonna get those shots.
English with 5 to shoot. Guarded by James, jumper over him, got it.
It was like make 500, and I was like, I'm just trying to double it, make 1,000, you know, a day.
I mean, it was great because we made the tournament again, my first time since I was a freshman. So yeah, we gave a good game in the first round against Iowa State.
And down we go. What a pace. English steals it. English now with Thomas back. English first made 7 straight field goals before that layup.
Your time in Nurshell playing for Tim Clues, how will you remember it?
just great. You know, he gave me a chance when a lot of people I felt like passed up on me. You know, I'm thankful to be able to play with a coach like that, and not just him, the whole coaching staff, you know.
Although Tim Kloos's Gales were not able to shock the world and knock off Iowa State today, this will go down as one of the most memorable seasons Iona basketball has ever had. Knocking off the conference champion Monmouth Hawks, it's a season that Tim Kloos and these players will never forget.
Like I said, Coach Kloos always puts you like in that mindset, you know, you gotta just put your best foot forward and always work hard.
Portsmouth comes up in April. You know, I hope to be able to attend that. I'm not physically very, you know, adept at moving around commercially, sitting on bleachers in a high school gym, etc. But I know that's kind of a place where, you know, you could get talent. We're going to do that type of thing.
It was great. You know, I was, like I said, I was blessed to be on the team with my, I feel like my whole team could have got an invite to Chicago, how we were playing and sharing the ball and things like that, and the players that was on our team. We won, you know, so we were competing, great coaches.
You guys have this lead is because you're selfless, man. Sharing the basketball. I haven't seen one selfish person and one selfish play in this locker room.
Like I said, I was just blessed that I was able to win a championship and get MVP.
Perfect. Thank you. You know how many you had in life? 26.
And you, the Utah Jazz workout, and I got the text. Everybody was texting my phone and saying that you made it to the combine. And I was like, really? And it was just, like I said, I was just thank God.
AJ English came in here, and a lot of people were wondering if he could rise to the level of the players who were playing at the combine. And after he'd won the MVP in Portsmouth, he came in here, and the first game he played, he put up 22 points. But, you know, at this point in the season, you look at him and you say, did we miss something? And for some of the teams, the answer is, yes, you missed something. You know, they're making up for lost time now, and they're, you know, looking back at synergy and trying to get, you know, some tape on him with his big scoring games, which he had plenty of to watch. He's a guy who everybody in the NBA surely knows now, and the name recognition doesn't hurt either, because he has father who played in the NBA with the same name, AJ English.
But like this process, lonely? Of course, I mean, you flying places by yourself, you know, you're meeting new people.
People just gotta understand, you know, exactly what you're going through. You know, you just, it's a lot of, like I said, a lot of lonely times, and a lot of times that you, of course, you miss and you love all those people even more. You appreciate them more that you're, when you're not around them as much, but at the same time, like, they gotta understand, you know, you're chasing, pursuing your dream.
Never give up, you know, never ever give up, you know, it's a business, you know, some people are gonna like you, some people gonna hate you, you know, some people gonna think you're just all right, you know, it's just gonna be a lot of opinions. So, I mean, just always stay in the gym. At the end of the day, just stay in the gym. Like, I can't even tell you, mindset of everything help you out a lot and keep your confidence up, but just really, really put that time in the gym. Just stay in the gym.
I expect to see AJ English in the NBA.
Right there, the chill go right there.
Okay, you got stopped.
You stopped.
You stopped.